வணக்கம். வைஸ் பிரசிடென்ட் ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கையா நாயுடுஜி, குருமூர்த்திஜி, ரஜினிகாந்த்ஜி, ரீடர்ஸ் அப் துக்லக், ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் வணக்கம். This is an occasion of double delight. 50 years of Tughlaq magazine and this program is being held when Tamil community worldwide is marking Pongal. Iniya Pongal Valtukkal. I would have loved to be there among you, but technology has been of a great help in bringing us together. In any case, for this magazine, its readers, and this illustrious legacy, I am no guest. Friends, in all this happiness, there is also one regret. The regret, Cho is not with us today. But Cho remains with us in our thoughts. He will be very proud of the progress this magazine has made in the last 5 decades. Cho had a special style of journalism. For him, 3 things were fundamental. One was facts. Facts are most important. They give moral strength to the report. Second, watch intelligent arguments. Any reader seeking to formulate an opinion will always appreciate intelligent arguments as they are logical and based on reason. Third, watch unique to Cho, only and only Cho. He had extensive focus on satire. The first page of Tughlaq carries a satirical cartoon. Satire is the best way to make your point and educate people. Cho was the master of satire. Most people from the political class were thankful that Cho edited magazine was a weekly one and not a daily newspaper. Just imagine, if it came out daily, friends, the dynamism of Tamil Nadu and the Tamil people amazes me. Tamil Nadu has been a guiding light for our nation for centuries. Here, economic success mixes beautifully with social reform. This land is home to the world's oldest language. In September last year, I had the honor of saying a few lines in Tamil language during my United Nations address. Many people wrote to me that they felt very proud hearing it. Friends, Over the last few years, many efforts have been made for Tamil Nadu's progress. When we took the ambitious decision of setting up two defense corridors, Tamil Nadu was a certain choice for one of them. This corridor will bring more industry to the state and boost employment opportunities for the local youth. Friends, the textile sector plays a vital role in Tamil Nadu's progress. The central government is modernizing the sector to help citizens. Financial assistance has been provided under the National Handloom Development Program. Two mega handloom clusters are to be set up. Resources have been allocated for machinery modernization as well. Friends, fisheries is one of the most upcoming sectors today. We want to make the fisheries sector more vibrant. Our focus is on technology, financial assistance, and human resource development. Just a few days back, deep sea fishing boats and transponders were handed over to the fishermen from Tamil Nadu. Our fishermen have been linked with Kisan credit cards. Now, fishing harbors have been built for fishermen. Help is being given to boat modernization too. Friends, we are also working round the clock to boost India's tourism sector. I am happy to share that over the last 5 years, foreign tourist arrival to India has gone up significantly. So has the foreign exchange and from tourism. The World Economic Forum released a Travel and Tourism Competitiveness Index. In those rankings, India's ranking now stands at 34. When we took office, India was at rank 65. Our improvements over the last few years has been noted by the world. I urge you all to visit at least 15 places in India in the coming 2 years. Last year, the majestic shores of Mamallapuram welcome Chinese President Xi Jinping. I am told this led to great interest in the Mamallapuram and Tamil Nadu. Keeping this spirit, I request you to invite your friends from other parts of India to visit one place in Tamil Nadu every year. You will be glad to know that Tamil Nadu is greatly benefiting due to the Union Government's Swadesh Darshan and Prasad schemes. The coastal circuit from Chennai to Kanyakumari, Kanchipuram, and Velanakli are going to be made more tourist friendly. Friends, Tughlaq marks 50 years at a time when India marks 70 years as a republic. Our constitution carries traces of India's rich past and gives us a roadmap for making an India of our freedom fighters' dream. I bow to the people of India who have time and again upheld the spirit of the Constitution in letter and spirit. Now, as India enters a new decade, it is the very people of India who will guide India's growth trajectory and take it to new heights. I have always believed there are two essential reasons that our great civilization has prospered. The first is India's celebration of harmony, diversity, and brotherhood. The second reason is the will and zeal of India's people. Whenever the people of India decide to do something, no force has been able to stop them. My last 5 years in government have validated this belief. We have made remarkable progress in several sectors because the change has been powered by the spirit of 130 crore Indians. If India has been able to move towards being ODF and achieve outstanding sanitation coverage, it is due to the people of India. If mindset have changed and the gender ratio is improving, infant mortality is falling, it is due to the people of India. When digital transactions witness historic rise, it is due to the people's proactive nature. Friends, the people of India no longer want to be spectators, but they want to be active stakeholders in taking our nation forward. Why else would senior citizens give up the railway concessions on one request? Why else would a pensioner donate significant part of his pension towards a cleaner India? Why else would over 1 crore people give up their gas subsidies? There are many such examples. As governments or media houses, we will have to respect the spirit and keep pace with it. Here, I would also like to appreciate the role of the media. They have taken forward every possible noble mission of nation building, be it cleanliness, reducing single-use plastic, and protecting the environment. I hope the same spirit gets reinforced in the time to come. Friends, one of the things I found when I came to Delhi was that those who got the opportunity to rule the nation for many, many years love to keep things in pendulum mode. We all know what a pendulum is, moving here, moving there. Keep things uncertain. Cause the problem, further it, and then pretend to solve it. Things have changed now. Our government has taken up the mission to solve problems persisting for decades. Take the example of the removal of Article 370 and 35A, abolition of triple talaq, or making GST a reality, or issue like 10% reservation for the upper caste poor, increased maternity leave up to 26 weeks, healthcare for the poor and middle class through Ayushman Bharat, setting up of OBC commission. The list is very long. Our decisions have helped further India's economic and social integration. Today, as India is developing at a rapid pace, and things that were seen as impossible are becoming a reality, the same vested interest group is unable to digest the changes. They are trying their level best to mislead, confuse, and cause unrest. In such times, the responsibility of a magazine like Tughlaq increased to keep the people of India aware, just as Cho would have done. With this, I once again congratulate you on this special occasion and end my remarks. Thank you. Thank you very much.